Well, hi there. I'm NBC2 First Alert meteorologist Rob Duns, and today we're going to talk about the ingredients necessary to put together a tropical storm and a hurricane. Now, you might think it's kind of funny that a meteorologist is talking to you about tropical storms and hurricanes inside a big kitchen instead of something like a big, beautiful TV studio like we have here at NBC2. But the reason I'm in the NBC2 kitchen today is because there's actually a lot of similarities in ways that you can relate to other things that you're already very familiar with to learn about how the ingredients come together to form a tropical storm and a hurricane. All right, so here's what we're going to try and do today. What we're going to do is we're going to make one of my favorite snacks to make myself. It's called a lemon chia seed muffin. It's super healthy for you, and even better, it tastes super good. These are the ingredients that I absolutely have to have in order to form a proper lemon chia seed muffin. I have to have 2 tablespoons of chia seeds, 1 cup of flour, 2 lemons, 1/4 cup of almond milk, 2 tablespoons of applesauce, some vanilla, brown sugar, baking soda, and baking powder. If I don't have all of these ingredients together, I'm not going to be able to form a tropical storm, a lemon chia seed muffin. All right, so here's what we want to do pretend. Let's pretend that we had all the proper ingredients together and we baked it at 350 degrees Fahrenheit for 35 minutes, which is exactly what the recipe calls for. The result would look something like this. Doesn't this look great? That is a proper lemon chia seed muffin, and it looks awesome. Now, for instance, let's consider if we forgot to put in, say, the brown sugar and the applesauce. So what we did is we forgot to put in 2 very important ingredients. The result is that instead of getting a great looking muffin like we did when we followed the instructions, the result now is that we kinda get a muffin, but I don't know, that doesn't look like a really good muffin to me, right? The reason why is we forgot to put some of the ingredients in this muffin, which is why it didn't come out quite as perfect as the first muffin. Now, for instance, just for a great example, let's say we forgot to put in the brown sugar and the applesauce and the baking powder and the baking soda, and instead of baking it at 350 degrees Fahrenheit for 35 minutes, I only baked it at 200 degrees Fahrenheit for 10 minutes. Well, the result would look kind of like this. Yuck. I'm not going to want to eat that. That looks disgusting, right? That's a terrible looking muffin. And the reason why is because I didn't have all the required ingredients to make a good looking muffin like I did in example number 1. So what on earth does this have to do with tropical storms and hurricanes, huh? Well, think of it this way. If this is the ingredient list that I have to form a proper lemon chia seed muffin, this is the ingredient list that I have in order to form a hurricane. All right, so you need these ingredients to form a lemon chia seed muffin. There we go. And you need these ingredients in order to form a hurricane. So let's go through these one by one, and we'll take a look if we can form a hurricane together. The number 1 ingredient, and perhaps the most important ingredient, is warm water. Now, when I say warm water, I'm not just talking like kind of warm. I'm talking like super warm. I'm talking about warm ocean water in the Atlantic Ocean, or the Gulf of Mexico, or the Caribbean Sea, that has to be at least 80 degrees Fahrenheit. So when mom and dad watch the news here during hurricane season, something they're going to be listening to this summer is what are the water temperatures in the Atlantic Ocean, the Caribbean Sea, and the Gulf of Mexico. If the water temperature is colder than 80 degrees Fahrenheit, it's not going to be able to release enough energy in order to form a giant tropical storm or a hurricane. By the way, do you happen to know what the average water temperature is off of our shoreline in the Gulf of Mexico during the middle of the summer? Sometimes I've seen the water temperature in areas like Naples and Fort Myers Beach be as warm as 90 degrees Fahrenheit. That's way warm enough for us to get a tropical storm or a hurricane to form, which again is ingredient number 1. All right, so again, warm water, that's ingredient number 1 for us to form a hurricane. Ingredient number 2 is rising air. Now, you know from living in Florida, especially during the summertime, that when it gets super hot outdoors in the afternoon, we sometimes see big, white, puffy cumulus clouds develop. And as the afternoon rolls on, sometimes those big, white, puffy cumulus clouds turn into giant, dark storm clouds, right? The reason why is because air is being forced to rise. As it rises, it cools, it condenses, and it turns into showers and downpours and thunderstorms. This is a very important part of the tropical storm and hurricane process because without some kind of disturbance over the top of the warm ocean water, there's nothing for it to eventually form into a tropical storm and a hurricane. So during hurricane season, when you watch the news with mom and dad or grandma and grandpa, what they'll be listening to when we deliver the weather reports are there any disturbances or areas of showers and downpours and thunderstorms over top of the Atlantic Ocean or the Gulf of Mexico or the Caribbean Sea that could potentially down the road turn into a tropical storm or a hurricane. All right, let's go back to our ingredient list. Next thing I have to have is something called weak wind shear. Now, this is something that gets a little advanced, and you'll learn more about it when you get to high school and college. But the way to think of wind shear is to think of how fast the wind is moving and what direction the wind is moving from the bottom of the atmosphere to the very top of the atmosphere. When we have a situation like this, in a setup called weak wind shear, the winds from the very bottom of the atmosphere to the very top of the atmosphere aren't very strong. And what happens is when that rising air, giving us showers, downpours, and thunderstorms moves along, the weak wind shear is not strong enough to mess around with these big showers and downpours and thunderstorms. And the result is that they can grow bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger and eventually, perhaps down the road, turn into a tropical storm or a hurricane. The opposite of weak wind shear, what do you think it is? Strong wind shear, very good. Strong wind shear is when we have faster winds in the upper parts of the atmosphere. So in this situation, we have light winds down here toward the bottom of the Earth's atmosphere, but very, very strong winds toward the top of Earth's atmosphere. Look at how this storm cloud is different than in the first cartoon I showed you. Do you see how this storm cloud is literally bending over because it's being pushed in one direction? When downpours and showers and thunderstorms are pushed over like that in one direction, it makes it really, really difficult for them to come together and form into a tropical storm and a hurricane because it makes it really tough for them to be organized. So if we have a case of strong wind shear, that's a case where sometimes it's very difficult for us to get a tropical storm or a hurricane. And on the flip side, if we have a case where there's light wind shear, that's an ingredient that's necessary to form a tropical storm or a hurricane. So during hurricane season, when you're watching the news with mom and dad or grandma and grandpa, if you hear myself or one of our other meteorologists at NBC2 talk about an area of weak wind shear over top of the Atlantic Ocean and the Gulf of Mexico and the Caribbean Sea, let that perk up your ear, because as you now know, that's an ingredient necessary to potentially form a tropical storm or a hurricane. All right, last number here on our ingredient list, number 4, would be open water. All right, think back to the very first ingredient we talked about. Do you remember what it was? Let's go back to our cards. The very first ingredient that we talked about that we have to have to form a tropical storm or a hurricane is warm ocean water. And remember, that water has to be at least 80 degrees Fahrenheit. When a tropical storm or a hurricane moves from the water onto land, we just took away the first ingredient, right? Remember, you can't form a tropical storm or a hurricane if you don't have ingredient number 1. If you take away ingredient number 1 from a tropical storm or a hurricane, it's like you're taking a piece of your ingredient list right out of the equation. So if you already have a tropical storm or a hurricane, maybe it looks like this, it would weaken into our not quite so good muffin. And if you take away even more ingredients, it would basically weaken into a much, much weaker system. So quickly to review, the 4 things that we really have to have in order for a tropical storm or a hurricane to form would include warm ocean water that's at least 80 degrees Fahrenheit. We have to have rising air, basically a cluster of showers or downpours or thunderstorms. We have to have an environment with weak wind shear over top of the Gulf of Mexico, the Caribbean Sea, or the Atlantic Ocean. And of course, you've got to have lots of warm, open water, because if we have a bunch of land, it's difficult for that tropical storm or hurricane to organize. All right? Does that make sense? Sounds good. I'm going to enjoy my lemon chia seed muffin, and I'll see you guys next time.